Hey, what's up, guys? I'm Cam.
And I'm Bucky.
We're from Down with Webster, and we're here with Canada's Talent.
What do you guys like best about being in Canada's capital?
What do we like being in Canada's capital? It's a very nice city. I like the scenery. I also like the radio station. I like 89.9. They're nice enough to put on these shows for us and have us in, so that's always cool.
It's kind of funny. Every time we've come here, we've only kind of stayed on this one block. So
yeah.
I haven't really seen much of the rest of the
shawarma's city. Cool. There's shawarma over there.
Yum.
Yeah. Cap went to university here.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he went to Carleton. He didn't graduate. He was there briefly.
What did he study?
God knows. I don't know. I'm going to go on a limb and say political science.
Okay.
If it's wrong.
Cap doing poli sci.
Yeah.
All
right. Right now you have one album out, the Time to Win Volume 1. Mm-hmm. And I think you're currently working on the second part, Volume 2.
Yep.
When can we expect that to be released?
Early in 2011.
So you guys had a large fan base even before you got signed. How did you promote yourselves in those days?
We used to run around downtown Toronto with like a bucket full of water and flour. Kind of pasting up flyers for ourselves, and Facebook, MySpace was always really big, and Facebook were really big, and just word of mouth, like we all had a bunch of friends, and it started off with just our friends coming to see our shows with and bringing their friends.
The tell your friends moment.
Yeah, and then it sort of snowballed.
So you guys have known each other for a while, some of you. Who were the original members who knew each other like from growing up, like from when you were kids?
Well, that's the thing. We all knew each other kind of growing up, but, like, we all officially joined the band at different stages. But, I mean, we've been, like, half of us were all on the T-ball team together. Like,
yeah, like, I've known these guys since I was, like, 12, some of them since I was 10.
Yeah, before
all
we
of
even,
you?
Yeah, the majority of us, yes.
Who's Webster? Where'd you get the band name from?
It actually came from, like, nothing. It's just a bunch of kids in being 12 and whatever happens to pop in your mind.
When you're 12, you say stupid stuff, and that happened to be one of them, and it just sort of stuck. It caught, and then we were like, should we change the name? Like, when we were, like, 15 or so, we're like, should we change the name? And then everyone's like, nah, just keep it. I think it was originally Emmanuel Lewis. So, what's up, Manny?
Yeah.
Some of you guys have stage names, and then you've got your real names. Does that ever get confusing when you're with each other?
Those stage names are the real names. We go by those names everywhere. Buck's mom calls him Buck. I call Cap, so.
Do any of you guys live together or, like, close by?
Yeah, well, we all live in the same neighborhood, and me and Cap actually lived together for a while. Didn't work out so well, so, yeah.
Since you guys are such good friends, how do you balance like your work life with your personal life?
There's no in between.
It's the same.
It's just life. It's all of it. Yeah.
When you were younger, what was on your bedroom wall? Like posters and whatnot.
I really remember loving a Mario 3 poster I had. That's pretty much about
Bob Marley. I think Bob Marley's still on your wall.
Yeah, and Bob Marley. But that's kind of like a staple. You kind of just get a Bob Marley poster to get a Bob Marley
poster. And it never goes anywhere. I'm pretty sure I had like a Wu-Tang poster on my wall forever.
Actually, I had a Wu-Tang poster as well, and it was like one of those really like overly big Wu-Tang posters.
Yeah, it was sick. Those ones were good.
Okay, so now we have a rumor segment. So we're going to give you guys a statement sent in by the fans, and you guys are going to say true or false.
All right. Thanks.
Okay, so you guys met in Berlin at the Youth Orchestra.
True.
False. We made that up in an interview when we were like, I don't know, 18 years old. We thought it was funny to like, you know, lie and say stupid stuff. But I'm telling you all, that's fake. Yeah, I've never been to Berlin or to a youth orchestra.
Okay.
All right.
But you're telling us the truth.
Right? I'm telling you the truth, yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Marty and Bucky went to the Cardinal Carter Academy for the Arts in Toronto.
True.
True?
Yeah.
Very true.
Cap was a child actor who voiced cartoons such as Little Bear, Franklin.
That's true. And Babar.
And Babar. Sonic the Hedgehog.
Sonic the Hedgehog, Babar, Franklin.
That's me.
And Roly Poly Oli. He was in Goosebumps.
Really?
He was all over the place. Yeah. He was in a holiday movie with Randy Travis called A Holiday to Remember, and it still airs every Christmas time. It's hysterical. If you see it, watch it. He's like 6 years old. It's awesome.
Definitely watch that.
Yeah.
Bucky made tea for people at the Woe Is Me video shoot.
Did I? I couldn't.
No, that's false. That's false. I've never seen Bucky make tea in his life.
True.
That it didn't happen.
Cam went to university for a year.
Yes, that is true. I did.
And what did you study?
I studied multimedia and communications. And it didn't work out. I wasn't communicating well. I had to leave.
Too much multimedia?
It's too much. No, I just want to do music.
Tyler started the band.
Yeah, Tyler was one of the guys who started the band.
So now we've got most likely two. So you're going to nominate a guy in the band for each category.
Okay.
So most likely two live in a treehouse.
Cap.
Yeah, for sure. I can't believe he hasn't done it yet.
Most likely to have 10 children.
Ooh. Marty.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Most likely to win a Nobel Prize.
Ooh. Pat?
Pat, maybe, yeah.
Pat? For what, though?
I don't know. Science of some sort. He's in his basement all day doing God knows what.
Most likely to get ID'd forever.
Again, Cap, probably.
Yeah, probably. He'll get ID'd for a long time.
Most likely to get married.
Marty.
Marty, again, yeah. That's part of the having the 10 children.
Most likely to burn down a house with their cooking.
Ooh. Oh. Bucky? Yeah, Bucky's going to burn something down.
Yeah. It's not. I'm pretty good at cooking, but I do burn things down.
Yeah.
most likely to climb up a tree to save a cat.
Me.
Bucky. Bucky likes cats a lot.
I like them.
He's into them.
Most likely to have a town named after you.
Hmm.
Me.
Bucky again.
Yeah, there's going to be Bucktown. It already happened, see?
Bucktown, Ontario.
To wrestle an alligator and win.
Me.
Yeah.
Most likely to wrestle an alligator and get eaten.
Oh.
Diggy.
Yeah.
So that would happen. Some fan questions.
Yeah.
They want to know, what are your pet peeves?
I got a few, but it's one of those things where I don't really notice them until it's happening.
Sharing hotel beds is one of Bucky's huge pet peeves. Yeah, he refuses to do it. He will sleep on the floor before he shares a bed with anyone.
What artist would you guys like to collaborate with in the future?
Oh, man. There's too many to say. I feel like if I said one name, I'd be shortchanging, like, at least 20 others. So I'm going to pass on that one.
Yeah, same thing. There's way too
many. It's already a collaboration. There's so many of us.
Are any of you guys single?
Yeah.
Bucky single, Marty single,
Diggy single,
Diggy single.
Think about it. He's single.
Is that it?
Yeah, I think that's it.
All right. They also wanted to hear a childhood memory from each of you.
I remember when I first got my Fisher Price tape deck, and started making dumb radio shows when I was a kid. That was fun.
That's awesome.
I don't know. First thing to pop in my head right now.
I remember when I was in grade 6 going into grade 7, I went to my junior high for like a check out the school kind of moment. I was with my parents and stuff. And Bucky was a grade older than me. And he was in the actual show for the presentation of the school. And I don't know how they let him do this, but they had turntables on the stage. And he was scratching with his foot. And I thought it was the coolest thing ever. I'm like, I'm going to this school for sure. This is amazing. So that's a memory.
Cool. Okay, so before the interview's over, would you guys like to give a message to the fans?
You tell them. You're good at talking.
Message to the fans. Come out to the show. I hope to see you all very soon. And if you can't make it out, hit us up on Facebook because I'm there all day.
What's up? I'm Cap from down with Webster. Follow Canada's Talent on Twitter.